Why do people act like someone's threatening to throw a hammer at their ballsack if they don't read this chapter? Like, some people just really seriously annoy me and they jump the gun and they just piss me off. Anyway, to get to the point, this chapter I enjoyed, I had a few issues with, but for the majority of the part I really love this chapter. Let's talk about what I didn't enjoy about the chapter. Is by the fact of when I got to page 9, it felt as if I learned literally nothing and it was just fight after fight after fight after fight, which is awesome if you're gonna extend the chapter out a little bit more. But there is one thing I cannot deny with them first 9 pages. I've just Yoruichi and asking going ham. I can't deny that through looking at these pages, and I mean I looked at these pages for a long good while, and I just got to appreciate the art when it comes to faces, close-up shots, attacking, everything just seemed very dramatic. It felt cinematic. I just loved how Kubo presented that fight and just appreciating the artwork within that. Everything was just clean, everything looked good, Yoruichi looked babe, and I really hope there's going to be some really good colors of them panels in particular, because they're just beautiful. They are. It really made me reappreciate Kubo's artwork, and that's the one plus I can give it to it. I just feel like if you're going to do 9 pages of just like no real dialogue, then it should have been extended a little bit more, but I did appreciate it. Now, I am going to say the formula of Kubo's writing is a bit of the same. Now, I'm not saying this in a bad way, because of course that would be me jumping the gun. What I am hoping for next chapter is that Grimmjow comes in. I don't want Urahara to finish off this fight, even though it seemed like he was going to finish off this fight anyway. He was saying, you know, all right, Yoruichi, you've had your thing. I'm going to go in now and retrieve the body to heal you and whatnot. Obviously, I don't think Urahara, you know, expected that he was going to get up. I think he had the plan of if that happens, but I think, you know, he thought that he had damaged him enough to quickly submit him. I don't think he was dead, but I think Urahara was thinking he was going to get his unconscious body or something like that. I'm not quite sure what Urahara was thinking, because I don't think Urahara is that stupid to not think of the possibilities of a holy form, etc. So, but it was a very generic formula to go on for a fight. Obviously, Yoruichi gets a power up, asking then gets his power up, which, come on, let's be fucking honest, if you want to sit here and complain that, oh my god, it was predictable, fucking he was gonna get a holy form, but then people would have bitched if he didn't. Obviously this was a thing we all knew was gonna happen. It was all about a matter of when. So I don't understand people's logic with moaning and bitching about, oh my god, it was so predictable, he was gonna get a holy form. So you're telling me at any other point, if he was gonna get a holy form, you would have bitched and moaned? Or if he didn't get a holy form, you would have bitched and moaned anyway? I don't get the logic in some people. Some people just fucking annoy me. It's all about how you present yourself. Yeah, something can be predictable, but if it's done in a correct way, it can have that same effect. Did it have that same effect this chapter? Not really, but I am expecting big things for the next chapter, and I'm hoping that Grimmjow does come back and redeem himself. And the thing of what I like he did with Yoruichi is actually cap her to that 5-minute mark. Yeah, we got this explosiveness of what Yoruichi can do and defeating Asking and this whole 48 times per second thing, which I'll get on into in a minute, because obviously that, I don't think it is a random number at all, but I like that she was capped and she was limited to what she could do, because obviously if she won this fight, then it's a convenience, and obviously of course Yoruichi would win, and that's predictable. So everyone likes to think that Bleach is predictable, yet they never can say what's going to happen the next chapter. It's fucking hilarious. Anyway, I digress. But it was a nice thing of Kubo to demonstrate her powers, what she can do, why this was degrading for Yoruichi. But I really want more backstory on how she did that the first time. Why did she need to do that the first time? And I'd love to go a little bit more on that in between the fight, would have even been nice. But I just love Kisuke's attraction to all this, of like him just trolling, asking while he's been beaten by Yoruichi, and then going, Yoruichi-san, it's playtime, and then she starts licking him. Like, oh my god, you lucky motherfucker. Now, the whole 48 times per second thing, people might think it's a random number and all that, but, and I haven't really done the research on this, so this is going to be very vague, but as far as I believe, it's something to do with electricity and hertz, like 48 hertz per second, and I think it's either something to do with frame rate or something like that, or it's to do with electricity amplification. Not quite sure. As I said, I hadn't researched into it, but I feel there is something along that line. So you have to do is Google it and you'll get somewhat of a vague answer whether it has some kind of connection. I don't know. That's up for you guys to decide. Just thought I'd throw that out there to see if anyone can make sense of that, because I did think, okay, that is very specific and that is, you know, I don't think that's particularly a random number. But again, people were complaining that it seemed a little bit over the top, exactly 48 minutes. So I did double check that, and it does have somewhat some convenience with electricity anyway. So that's a little nice thing to go on anyway, whether I'm researching that correctly. But let's talk about Urahara, because I don't think Urahara is going to release any kind of Shikai or Bankai within this fight. Again, that would be too predictable, and I don't think Urahara really intended to go up against Asken. As we've said, he wanted to originally just go to get the body to heal Yoruichi and Yashiro. So maybe that was a little bit why he was shocked that he was still alive, even though I think that he knew that he had a holy form, but he thought obviously he could probably take him out before he got to that stage. That's why he was probably a little bit shocked by that and probably miscalculated a bit. But I don't think it's Kubo's intention to waste a Shikai or Bankai on Asken. I think he wants to do that more on a bigger fish later on down the road, depending on who that would be. If it's the old Gotei 13, if it's your watch, if it's Hushworld, who knows? But, or even possibly Aizen, who knows? But I don't think we're going to get Urahara's Bankai just yet. I think we're just getting blueballed. But to keep it short and sweet, I just think this was a really good redemption for Yoruichi losing against Asken, and then Urahara giving her the means to give that redemption of her kicking ass, giving her that reputation to why she is a bad bitch, and the reason to why we know that Yoruichi is so fucking strong. So it just gives us that, you know, little extra that she's been capping herself all this time. So a little bit of redemption for Yoruichi, but also I'm hoping that next chapter we get a little bit of redemption for Grimmjow as well, coming in, fighting a holy form Asken with hopefully a second release or a first release. I don't know, but I hope Grimmjow gets that redemption very quickly. So I'm excited. Tell me, of course, your thoughts in the comment section down below, guys. What did you think of this chapter? What did you think of the artwork? Did you appreciate the artwork? What do you think about Urahara? Do you think he is going to fight Asken? Do you hope for Grimmjow to come in next chapter to break that mold of formula that Kubo has got? And what do you think for Yoruichi? Do you think this definitely redeemed her as a character for her fight with Asken prior? So with that being said, I'm going to catch you, motherfuckers, let you guys, of course, have this fine day been hansened, and peace out.